online generation, we certainly remember those of us old enough to, a schoolyard bully. However, today's children, it's cyberbullying, and it's very real, it's vicious, and potentially a life-threatening phenomenon. Joining us today to discuss cyberbullying, UAB psychologist, thank you so much for being here with us, as always, Dr. Josh Claypo. Okay, so we've had a lot of attention on bullying in recent years, so how big of a problem is the online component of it now?
It's kind of confusing. Overall, we're seeing decreases, overall, which is good.
Sure.
But it's still very prevalent. And let me say this, I think this is really important, not just online bullying, but any kind of bullying. This is not about kids who can't take a joke. Mm-hmm. This is not about kids being teased once or twice,
it's
or
relentless.
Snowflakes, that kind of thing. This is any kind of bullying, it's systematic, it's targeted, it is repeated, and it's going after a particular person, whether that's an adult or a child. So there's a big difference between teasing and bullying. The cyberbullying, though, that what's so scary about cyberbullying is, unlike what we're used to on the playground or at the school,
where you could kind of walk away,
right, 24/7. There is no boundary to it. The other thing about cyberbullying that makes it even more potentially vicious is complete anonymity.
Sure.
There is, you don't have to look at the bully.
Make up
the bully.
An account
exactly. So one of the things that's important is it can often go unnoticed, and it never stops, and that's why we have to be concerned about it.
Okay, so what do adults do to help prevent this or keep an eye on their children? And not just not let them be bullies, but not let them be bullied, right?
It's challenging. I would say this, particularly for younger children. If your younger child, elementary school, is on a computer, you want to be able to see that computer. I know that as technology comes forward, it makes it more and more difficult, but you want to be able to see the computer. If you can't do that, and particularly with teens, you need to have a house rule that basically says you're going to do spot checks, which means you're going to look at their accounts, they are going to show you their accounts, and as much as that becomes can become an issue, you need to do that so you can stay aware. The other thing you need to do is to actually teach your teens and your young children what is cyberbullying.
Sure.
So the idea of repeated messages so that they understand maybe something is going on. Those things are going to help prevent it, but it still can happen.
So say you discover it, you know, what do parents, your kid is being bullied, for instance, what do parents who find themselves in that situation, what do they do?
Natural inclination is immediately go out and contact the bully.
Sure.
Don't do that, number one.
Makes
number
it
two,
worse.
Yes, absolutely. Number two, do not erase messages or any sort of text, etc. Take screenshots. You want to get that information. You absolutely want to see if you can locate where the computer's coming from. And then in particular, if there are messages, physical threats, extortion, pornography, then believe it or not, that is something that you need to take to the police.
It's a crime.
It is a crime. And we don't, again, we don't think about it that way as parents, but you absolutely need to, and the police can help you in that situation. It's something that is very...
It's tricky.
It's tricky, but you got to stay on top of
it. Absolutely. All right. Thanks so much, as always, Dr. Josh, for being here with us.